I'm back with Billy. We were late edition of the my Lucha Underground review. I meant to do this Wednesday before Impact, but I didn't get to catch it all. But now I'm gonna do it all to the best of my ability. This is my review for Lucha Underground November 12, 2014. Before I get to my review, I want to remind everyone to check out Big Bill 360 on Facebook and Twitter. Check out Andre Corbio, Big Ray Hernandez, and Big Bill Skyler with the Canon Wrestling Show every Saturday night on the Andre Corbio YouTube page, as well as the Facebook and Twitter accounts that should all be in the description, along with Bill Apno at OneWrestling.com and Apno One on Twitter. Like I said, everything should be in the description below. But now, let's get to Lucha Underground. We kick it off with the mini.
The mini? Nobody.
Known by just about everyone in the business.
Who's ever actually
watched early WWE and
Lucha Libre.
I know him because I saw him back in the early 90s, one of the WWE pay-per-views,
Masquerita,
Sagata taking on an average size star,
El
Mariachi Loco, as he was introduced by Dario Quintez.
Dario says
everybody been waiting for more Lucha stars, and he brought out El Mariachi
Loco
to take on Masquerita Sagata. Masquerita picks up the win for the guillotine
choke
into a roll up for the one for the pinfall victory. After the match,
Chavo Guerrero,
still on a path of destruction since the first episode,
he takes out
Masquerita Sagata. We move on
to
Mil Muertes, the monster led by he's led to the ring by Katrina.
By Katrina.
Who is who everybody may remember from WWE.
As Maxine.
From NXT, WWE's, back when,
NXT was more of a
game show at the time. I really thought she could have been something, but apparently they
didn't see anything at all.
They could have, but now she's leading
Mil Muertes
into battle against, Vicky Mandel, I believe I heard this thing before, if I'm not sure.
If I'm not
mistaken, I believe I heard that name before.
It may not be the same
person, but the same guy, but I've heard that name. Mil Muertes
picks up
the win for the flatliner for the pinball victory. We move on
to Johnny Mundo,
the former Johnny Nitro, backstage.
As he
takes out Dario Quintez's bodyguards.
Still don't remember their names.
He takes them out and bursts into the office.
And demands
a one-on-one match against Big Rick, formerly known as
Big Zeke.
And then tells after
Quintez
grants him his match, he tells him he's coming for him next. After a commercial break, we come back and we see Dario talking
in his office to
Big Rick as he's paying him off to take out
Johnny Mundo.
He says he wants him sent to the hospital next week.
And he pays him an
undisclosed amount of money to do so. As we move on
to the main event,
Phoenix, luchadors
that I don't believe I've seen before.
That haven't really been in,
haven't been on
Milk TV. Phoenix.
Phoenix with an F.
Takes, gets the pinball victory over Pentagon Jr. With a reverse ladder for the pinball.
It was a triple threat
match, which included luchador by the name of Drago.
High impact, high
luchador style match that I really enjoyed. Like I said,
Phoenix picked up the
win with a reverse ladder of Pentagon Jr.
for the
victory. I really enjoy Lucha Underground.
I hope it continues on
as long as possible. And I really like the feel that they give.
The,
backstage interactions, the backstage promos.
Promos and everything.
They have a very cinematic feel to them that I think will
set them apart
from other companies. But until next time,
I'm getting ready to do my work.
Leave for Ring of Honor. So that'll be up probably around the same time this one is.
So if you see it,
take a look, tell me what you thought of this show. Like, subscribe, comment,
and
check out my Ring of Honor review, as it should be up about the same time.
And let me know what you
thought of Lucha Underground and all my other
shows that I've reviewed
this week. Until the next video, I'm out of here. See you.